This is a vibe, I have to say. These lyrics are so good. Okay, this is interesting. She's really outdone herself. This makes me want to cry. Oh, cardigan, okay. That sent me on an emotional roller coaster. Hello everyone, it's Emma and welcome back to a brand new video. So you can probably tell from the title what this video is. And yes, your eyes are not deceiving you. This is a Taylor Swift album reaction video. And it's a brand new Taylor Swift album. We have TS8. Basically, Taylor decided that she wanted to surprise the entire world and be like, hey, guess what? I'm releasing my 8th studio album tonight at midnight. And it is now almost 12:30 currently. And she also dropped a music video for the song Cardigan, which I just reacted to. So if you wanna go check out that video, I'll have it in the iCard somewhere. I don't remember what side it's on. It's one of these sides. This video is actually probably going up before that one. So if that hasn't gone up yet, stay tuned. But if you're watching this in the future and that video is already up, go watch it. It was a fun time. I almost cried. Spoiler alert, oh my god, I can't believe that Taylor Swift released a new album. I'm like shocked, I don't know what to think. Oh my god, from what I heard from Cardigan, I don't remember much of it because I was paying attention to the video, but it sounded beautiful and I'm really excited. And yeah, also the album is alternative, which is different because, you know, she was pop there for a while, so I don't really listen to alternative music, but let's be honest, I'm probably gonna love it. It's Taylor Swift. Like, I'm gonna love it. Let's be real. So I'm excited. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. And if this is the first time that you're seeing my face and you're on my channel, then you should subscribe because it's a fun time here. And if you wanna see more Taylor Swift videos, then also give this video a like and turn on post notifications so that you never miss a video from me. And let's just get into the album reaction. I'm so excited. Oh my god. I can't contain it. I don't wanna wait any longer. Let's go. Okay, so I finally got the album on Apple Music. It wasn't on Apple Music for like a solid, like almost 30 minutes. Now it's finally on Apple Music. And like I said, it is alternative, which will be quite interesting. And there are 5 explicit tracks. This is Taylor's first ever explicit album. Now, yes, she did say shit on I Did Something Bad on Reputation, but that wasn't really labeled as explicit. But this time it's explicit. So I'm going to be listening to the explicit version. I don't know if there's a clean version or not. There probably is, but I'm going to be listening to the explicit version. I wonder if she's going to be dropping the F-bomb or not. I wonder. I'll be surprised. Okay, I kind of hope she doesn't because I'm not really a fan of that word, but you know what? We're gonna roll with it. We'll see. Okay, I'm excited. The first track is titled The One, and this is the first explicit song on the album. So let's go. Make sure I have my volume up. Okay, we're starting off slow. That's some piano. Okay. Well, I like it. I'm doing good, I'm on some new shit. Ooh. Been saying yes instead of no. This is a vibe, I have to say. So far. It's kinda cute. It's a little vibe. This would be really nice to just like for like a long like drive. And just like vibe, you know. Rose are flowing with your chosen family. I wonder what she's like singing about. Is she singing about like anyone in particular? Her voice is so heavenly. Oh my gosh. All right, that was cute. I want to say right off the bat, I don't think it's like gonna be one of my favorites, but I don't know, that might change. It's literally like technically the second song I've listened to because I listened to Cardigan, but that was cute. It was definitely very like, had a very chill vibe. I could definitely see like that song for like a long walk or like a long drive and just kind of like want a vibe, you know? I'm excited for the rest of the album and to see where the rest of it goes. Let's move on. The next song is actually Cardigan, and I'm actually going to listen to it again, even though I technically already listened to it with the music video, but I really don't remember like anything about it. So we're gonna listen to it. Let's go. Vintage tea, brand new phone. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. It's honestly true. I like this part. Dancing in your Levi's, drunk under a street light. I'm on and said I was your favorite. This is a vibe too. Oh my gosh, wait. She said, once in 20 lifetimes. Oh my gosh, shout out to Lover. You know, haven't known you 20 seconds or 20 years. We love a queen. We love. Okay, let's continue. These lyrics are so good. Okay, I think we're just fading out. I have to say, enjoyed it the second time as much as I did the first time. And I was able to like really pay attention to it more this time than I feel like I did the first time because I feel like I missed a lot. But wow. Holy crap. Lyrics? Wow. Can't wait to like dissect those and like analyze them later on because that'll be really cool. So now let's get on into the third song of this album. I'm excited. Okay, so the next song on the album is called The Last Great American Dynasty, and this one is also explicit. This one I'm actually excited for because I don't know what to expect. I mean, I don't know what to expect with any of the songs, but I'm excited for this one. I wonder if this one is going to be a little bit like Miss Americana, kind of like how she got a little like political or not. We're gonna see. I have a feeling it might be political, or it could be totally wrong. I don't know. We'll find out. Okay, this is interesting. Becca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny. Okay, she's talking about someone named Rebecca. Bill was the heir to the Standard Oil name. And now Bill. With money, there goes the last great American dynasty. Okay. Almost not what I expected. To be honest. This is interesting. She had a marvelous time. It was bought by me. Meaning she bought the house? She does own a house in Rhode Island. Oh, Taylor. Interesting. Again, not what I expected, actually. I thought it was going to be a little bit more like Miss Americana, and it really wasn't. Honestly, so far, I mean, I'm only like 3 songs in. I don't know. It's different. It's more like chill. It's definitely not like her other past albums, but we'll see where it goes. I'm still gonna give it a chance. So let's go to the next one. This one is called Exile featuring Bon Iver. I think that's how I'm saying his name. If I'm saying it wrong, I'm very sorry. I honestly don't know who that is. I think from what I gather, he's a singer. Never heard of him in my life. Until today. So this will be interesting. Another piano. I can see you standing on it. Okay. We are starting with the feature. Okay. Ooh, harmonies. Okay. So what am I defending now? I can hear Taylor like in the background a little bit. Like he's just your understudy. Like you get. Okay, I like that actually. That's funny. It's She was like, you never gave any warning signs. And she was like, I gave you so many signs. All right, it's building. Okay, so the next song is the infamous Track 5 song, and this one is called My Tears Ricochet. I'm not mentally prepared for this. I feel like this might be the end of me. So goodbye, world. It was nice knowing you. Okay, let's start. Ooh, that's pretty. Chef's kiss to this. Oh wow. We should not stay. Look at how my tears ricochet. Oh my god. Ugh, why is she such a lyrical genius? I don't understand. This makes me want to cry. I have to pause this for a second. Hold on. I need a moment of silence for these lyrics. Oh my god. I can't even process this right now. Oh my god. I mean, it may be the fact that it's literally 1 a.m. This is so beautiful. I'm crying in the club. Can this song just be played at my funeral? I mean, I think I was right when I said, you know, this is gonna be the death of me because... Okay, let's continue because this is clearly a masterpiece. Oh my god. Excuse me? Still miss me, can I still talk to you? I'm literally crying right now. Oh my god. Taylor, you've outdone yourself. I love Taylor so much. Oh, it's over. You guys, oh my god. I am not okay after that. That sent me on an emotional roller coaster. I want that played at my funeral. Like, no ifs, ands, or buts. I want that played. I think that's my favorite so far. I know I said that about Cardigan, but I think that's my favorite so far. We're gonna move on to the sixth song before I fully have a emotional breakdown over that song. The sixth song is called Mirror Ball. And part of me feels like this is gonna be about like a disco ball. I don't know, I have some theories in my head. We're gonna see. Okay, let's play. This is how we're doing this? Okay then. Good to know, Taylor, good to know. Really outdone herself. When no one is around, my dear, that was good. I don't think it quite touched the heightness that was track 5, but that was really good. That was really heavenly. Okay, now on to track 7, which is coincidentally titled 7. Let's go on to track 7. Please picture me. Shout out! Your braids like a pattern, love you to the moon and to Saturn, pass down like folk songs, the love lasts so. Okay. Okay, but I love. What? She literally said, love you to the moon and Saturn? I'm sorry, but yes? Yes? Okay, new favorite lyric. I want that tattooed on my forehead. It's almost 1:30 in the morning. I'm dying. Taylor Swift is the death of me currently. Okay, I'm being dramatic. Moving on. This album hits so different. Wow, she really put out all the stops on this production. She really was like, I'm making this a stellar album. She did that. She did that. Wow. Okay, next song is called August, which coincidentally is track 8. Also, spoiler alert, August is also the 8th month in the year. Taylor's mind. Taylor's mind. Let me tell you. All right, I'm excited for this one. This one, when like the track list first like came out this morning, I was like, yep, I claim track 8. And I hope I'm right. Because August, I saw Taylor on the Rep Tour in August. August 7th to be exact. Which is funny because she has a song called 7. And then August. So, you know, it's like, it's literally meant to be. I hope I love the song. Okay, I'm so excited. Salt air and the rust on your door. But I can see it's lost in the memory. Talk is slipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine. Oh wow. August slipped away like a bottle of wine? I know I've said this 1,000 times already, but like her mind. How does she come up with this stuff? I would like to know. Cancel plans just in case you call and say, meet me behind the mall. Wow. All right, that one was really good too. I really enjoyed that. That was really good. Okay, so the next song is called This Is Me Trying. I'm excited for the song. Also, this kind of reminds me of her Entertainment Weekly magazine cover, was it? That's not what it was. Where she had like the pins on like her jean jacket, and she had one that was like of a gravestone and it said I tried on it. This reminds me of that. Probably has no correlation, but it just reminds me of that. Okay, let's get into it. This is pretty. The lyrics are so good. I feel like this is another like flashlight song. This album is really top notch. Like wow. The melodies, wow. I like this one. That was a stellar song. That was really good. Wow. We are currently how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for 5. Wow. I'm actually impressed. I have to say the album at first started off a little slow for me, but now it's picking up. I'm excited to see where the rest of this album goes. We're 5 for 5. Maybe we'll be 12 for 12 on the next. I don't know. I don't know what the future holds. This Is Me Trying. What a stellar song. The next song is Illicit Affairs. I'm excited for the song. Don't know what it's gonna be about. I'm excited. Let's go. That's the thing about illicit affairs and clandestine meetings. Take the words for what they are. And you wanna swing, don't call me kid, don't call me baby. Look at this godforsaken mess that you made me. Oh, I love that. Oh, yes. Oh my god. Oh wow. Okay. Can we just take a moment to talk about those lyrics? She's made it seem so freaking heavenly. Oh my god. Okay. Next song is titled Invisible String. Let's do it. I'm ready. What does Miss Swift have in store for us for this song? Green was the color of the grass where I used to read at Centennial Park. Invisible string, tying you to me. Bad was the blood of the song in the cab on your first trip to LA. Bold was the richest on our 3-year trip, getting lunch down by 3-year trip? She said I looked like an American singer. Oh my god! Wait, is she talking about the trip that she took with Joe for their 3-year anniversary? I wonder where they went. They must have gone somewhere, like, private, I guess. Out of all the runs right into that dive bar. Oh, dive bar! Oh, we know that dive bar on the east side where you at. Oh, she clever. She clever. I see you, Taylor. I see you. Okay. Is she wearing like a necklace? Like gold? Like a thread of like gold? Like a necklace? You know, like chain around my neck? You know, with your initial on it? Call it what you want. Oh, that's pretty. Wow, that was good. Okay, so the next song on the album is titled Mad Woman, and this one is explicit as well, and part of me feels like this might be about how people say she's like a mad woman, maybe, like, kind of like, maybe like blank space, the man-esque. That's what I am predicting. I don't know if that's gonna have any correlation, or if it's gonna be like, wow, people think like I'm a mad woman or something. I don't know. Let's see. I'm ready. What do you sing on your drive home? Do you see my face in the name? What does she mouth? Fuck you forever. Every time you call me. Okay. Well, we got the F-bomb from Miss Taylor. She really just said that. Interesting. Now I breathe flames each time I talk. My cannons all firing at your yacht. It's obvious that wanting me dead has really brought you two together. Okay. Every time you call me crazy. Okay. I'm just wondering if this is about, like, Kanye and Kim. Like, provoking her. I almost wonder. Taking my time, since you took everything from me. Watching you climb, watching you climb. Could be. Over people like me. Good wives always know. Ooh. She should be mad, should be scathing like me. You know what? I'm realizing it could be about that. Okay, Miss Hooked. Okay, you know what? I can actually see that possibly being about Kim and Kanye. Low key. Don't know if it's actually about that. Like, let me preface. But, like, some of the lyrics, I can see it. I can see it, maybe. I don't know. But anyway, moving on to the next song, which is titled Epiphany. Miss Swift must have had an epiphany about something. I wonder what she had an epiphany about. Let's find out. That rhymed. That was unintentional. This is a long song. Is your falling off the beaches now? Sir, I think he's bleeding now. And something's oh, is this about her grandfather? Or something. She said something about like her grandfather in like 1942. It might be about that. Hold your hand through plastic now. Just one single glimpse of relief to make some sense of what you've seen. Only 20 minutes to sleep, but you dream of some epiphany. Okay, so I just read through the lyrics of that song. Wow. Those are some deep lyrics. Like, I definitely think that song was about her grandfather who landed in some place that I cannot pronounce in 1942 that she mentioned in her like little like intro thing for the album. Like, it's amazing how she can like get into the mind of like these people. Like, how she can like literally like tell these stories. It's like she lived it, but like she didn't. Like, that's crazy. Like, oh my god. Like, I know I keep saying this, but like, wow, the way that she can like tell story, like her storytelling, impeccable. I believe the next song is called Betty. I'm excited for this. Apparently, I think it's Joe's mom? I could be totally wrong about this. I think it's Joe's mom. That's name is Betty? So I don't know if this is like about her or if this is about like someone else named Betty. So we're gonna find out. This is also explicit. So ready for that. Let's rock and roll. We're almost done with the album. Wow. Okay. Okay, harmonica. Okay. Betty, I won't make a okay. About why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's 'cause of me. Is this about like her childhood? Thing that, yeah. Would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to myself? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me? Oh, if I told you wow. It was just a summer thing. I wonder who this Betty person is. The far side of the gym. Was it someone that she like I was nowhere used to be friends with? Like in a travel? I wonder. It could just be a fake name too. I like the melody though. It's cute. Oh wait, or is she writing this from like a guy's perspective? Betty, I'm here on I think I just got it. Betty, right now is the last time I just had an epiphany.
Okay.
Yep. I think I understand it now. Cardigan, okay. Okay, so I realized about halfway through what the song is about. It's not about like her childhood. So like she actually said something like there are three songs on the album that kind of like go together like in a triangle. And it's kind of like, it's like a love triangle type of thing.
So this is a song about a love triangle between three people that I made up.
And they're all from like different perspectives. And she sees them from like kind of like a teenager type of love. And I think this is one of them. Yeah, I definitely think this is one of them. I think this is from like the guy's perspective. Kind of like the guy is saying like, Betty, I still miss you, like type of thing.
There was a girl, we'll call her Betty.
She literally wrote from the perspective of a guy. That's crazy. I don't know what the other two songs would be in the triangle. Maybe like August? I don't know. I'd have to listen to the other songs again to like really like figure it out. I can see this one being one of them. If I figure it out, maybe I'll put like my predictions over here on the screen so you can take a look at them and if you agree or you disagree. I don't know. I don't know what this will tell us if, you know, if we're right or wrong or what songs they actually are. But moving on, we have two more songs left. The next song is called Peace and again is another explicit song. Let's go. Where is this gonna lead us to? A coming of age has come and gone. Suddenly this summer it's clear. Would it be enough if I could never give you peace? Give you my wild, give you a child. Give you the silence that only give you a child. People understand each other. Family that okay. Chose now that I see your brother as my brother. But there's robbers to the east, clowns to the west. I'd give you my wow. Sunshine, give you my best. But the rain is always gonna come if you're standing with me. Oh, I like that. That's cute. Okay, I don't think that one was like particularly one of my favorites. That was just okay. But with that, we now are leading into the last song on the album. So the last song on the album is called Hoax. Part of me feels like it might be about how people think this whole pandemic coronavirus thing is a hoax. Probably not. It's probably not even gonna be about that. I don't even know what to expect at this point because I feel like I have been wrong with my theories. I don't know. Let's just dive into it. My only one. My eclipsed sun. Eclipse. If you know, you know. Stood on the cliffside screaming, give me a reason. Your faithless love's the only hoax I believe in. You know what? You know round two, baby, round two. Back in New York, you knew the hero died, so what's the movie for? My scars from when they pulled me apart. Oh my god, these lyrics. You knew you won, so what's the point of keeping score? Wow. She's getting real deep on this album, man. Don't want no other shade of blue but you. Oh, that was so pretty. Oh wow. Solid way to end the album. Wow. 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 I think that was definitely an ending. I enjoyed that one, actually. I liked that. Solid ending. Solid ending. Well, with that, we have made it to the end of the album. Wow. All right. Let's talk about it. Let's discuss. Okay, guys. So, we did it. We listened all the way through to Taylor Swift's new album, Folklore. So, I think thoughts about it right now, I have to say, I don't think it's my favorite album by her at the moment. I think Lover and Reputation are still my favorites. Now this could change tomorrow. This could change in a week. I don't know. I don't know where I would place this album, to be honest. I almost feel like it deserves its own category because it's so different. Like, lyrically, oh, 100% one of her best. 100%. Melodies, one of her best. But, like, I don't know. I love Lover and I'm not over Lover yet. And I love Reputation. Like, that's just more of, like, my vibe and my style, but, like, honestly, this album is a vibe. It hits differently. I mean, y'all saw how I almost cried to track 5. I mean, almost cried. I definitely will be listening to this album more, but yeah, it is definitely very beautiful. Yeah, I think my favorite songs at the moment on the album are My Tears Ricochet, 7, August, Cardigan, Illicit Affairs, and maybe like Hoax. I think those are my favorites so far. I'll have like a full list of like my rankings of all the songs. But yeah, let me know in the comments down below. Did you love the album? Did you not really vibe with it? Or is it totally your vibe and you think it's her best album she's ever made? Let me know. So if you want to see more Taylor content on my channel, I can definitely do that. But anyway, if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. If you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed yet, you should subscribe because it's totally free. And turn on post notifications because you want to be notified whenever I post a new video. Also, I want to say real fast, please, please wear a mask when you're out in public because this whole COVID thing is crazy and it's currently winning right now. Like, we're losing the battle of COVID. So please wear a mask if you're out in public. It's not that hard. It's literally a piece of cloth over your face. It's a minor inconvenience. You can do it for 30 minutes. If someone who is working in a hospital can do it for 8, 10, 12 hours, you can do it for a half hour or however long you wear it while you're out. So that is my little TED Talk of the day. Yeah, let me know what you guys think of Folklore in the comments, like I said. And that is it from me today. I will talk to you guys later. Also, remember that you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and loved more than you know. And with that being said, I'm going to go to sleep now. Love you guys. I will talk to you guys in another video. Bye. My darling, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you.